on earth is this?
Oh, Miss Brennan.
Birdsworth, of course. This is your work, isn't it?
I don't know what you mean.
This muck, it smells revolting.
Oh, rat must have died in there.
It's some sort of alcoholic brew. It's...
Hold your horses.
Birdsworth, on your feet.
Lizzie, are you all right?
Of course she is. She's just pretended to faint.
Oh, Lizzie, stop playing funny buggers.
On your feet, Birdsworth.
Lizzie?
She's only doing this to avoid punishment.
It's a heart.
Rubbish. She's tried this trick once too often.
Well, this time it's for real. Just stand there. Shut up. Go and get some help.
She's having a heart attack, Vera.
Her lips are turning blue. Do something.
Stokes, find another officer. Tell her to get an ambulance. Quickly. Move!
Hang on, Lizzie, hang on. We're getting help.
She's dead!
Out of my way, both of you!
Is there any pulse?
Is she gonna be all right, Miss Bennett?
It's hard to tell, but at least there's a pulse.
Oh, you'll make it, Lizzie. You'll make it.
Well, I can't deny I'm glad to see the back of Stuart Gillespie.
I can imagine you are. Thank you. Of course, you realize the department will have to carry out some sort of follow-up. Oh, Gillespie put through some very damning reports.
Oh, yes, I'm sure he did. So I'm still going to have his shadow hanging over my shoulder, am I?
We can't sweep it all under the carpet. But of course, in the meantime, you can feel free to carry on as you did before.
You know, I wish that some of those academics with their fine theories of how to run prisons could know what we have to put up with. Oh, excuse me. Erica Davidson? Birdsworth? Well, how bad is she? I see. Did they say how long the ambulance would be? Yes, well, thank you, Wendy. You see, that's the sort of thing I mean. One of our women, Lizzie Birdsworth, you know her, has just had a very severe heart attack. They've given her first aid, and the ambulance is on the way. But I better go and see how they're getting on.
Well, look, is it all in hand?
Well, yes, I gather so.
Well, before you go, I'd like to tell you about my meeting with the secretary.
Oh, yes, how did you get on?
Well, briefly, they're going to establish an education facility here.
Oh, Ted, that's wonderful. I've often recommended it myself in the past, but they've never acted upon it. How soon can it begin?
Oh, pretty soon, I should imagine. It's only a matter of tying up a few loose ends. It'll be run by the education department and staffed by a trained teacher. So I don't think it'll add to any of your pressures. Well, in fact, I think it should relieve some of them.
Oh, I'm sure it will, if the women take an interest in learning. Well, your news has certainly cheered me up.
Good to have some good news for change, eh?
Yes. It will be a relief to know I'm running my own ship again, too. Even if the department is looking over my shoulder. How is she?
Oh, it's hard to say. I just hope those ambulance men can do something for her immediately.
I believe you acted very quickly, Miss Bennett.
Oh, I did what I could.
I'll be in touch, Erica.
Yes, Ted. Thank you for all your support.
I hope Birdsworth will be all right.
Oh, so do I.
Sounds like you did a good job, Miss Bennett. Congratulations. I won't hold you up.
What exactly happened?
I was passing the door of the recreation room when I smelt something strange. I went in to see what it was, and I found a bucket of some sort of homemade brew. Obviously highly alcoholic. The smell was disgusting.
Birdsworth's handiwork.
Yes, I'd say so. She came rushing in, trying to distract me. And then she collapsed. Of course, at first I thought it was just her usual act.
Well, it's understandable you'd think that. Lizzie's cried wolf so often in the past.
Yes, but then I saw how white she was. Well, her lips started to turn blue. I knew she wasn't faking that.
No.
She had no pulse, and she'd stopped breathing. She was dead, Mrs. Davidson. So I applied the external heart massage.
You probably saved Lizzie's life.
Yes, I hope so. But I intend to find out how they made that brew and who was responsible.
Well, I think you'd better get rid of it first.
Yes, I'll do that immediately. And then I'll start a thorough investigation. These women have got to learn that they can't get away with that sort of thing.
Wendy, would you ask Sister Franklin to contact the Wentworth Hospital and give them all the details on Lizzie Birdsworth? And let me know if there's any news.
Yes, I will, Mrs. Davidson.
She still looked pretty awful, Bea.
Yeah. Well, she certainly isn't going to be doing any tap dancing routines for a while, that's for sure.
Must be something on telly. Let's take our minds off it. Oh, damn, I forgot it wasn't working. Can't we do something about getting it fixed, Bea?
Oh, I'll speak to Mrs. Davidson about it sometime.
I don't know why I didn't think of mouth to mouth. I did it with Chrissy's baby. I just sat there and let Vera do the lot.
Shut up about it, can't you, Doreen?
Well, I was only...
Yeah, well, don't. You're only making us all feel worse.
Well, what else is there to think about?
I'll give you something to think about.
Pour the lot down the loo.
All right, where is it?
Don't know what you're talking about, Vera, so why don't you just give it a miss?
And let you get away with it.
After what happened to Lizzie, I don't think we're getting away with anything.
That's right. And what you did for Lizzie was pretty good, Miss Bennet.
Yeah, it was. Real good.
Well, don't think that you can sidetrack me like that. Because I know there was some sort of alcoholic brew in that cupboard. And I intend to find out who made it and how.
Well, that's going to be a bit difficult, isn't it? Seems to me your evidence is missing. And I didn't see any brew in there, did you, girls?
No.
Oh. You always pride yourself on knowing what's going on, Smith. So no doubt you knew all about this. So you can just come along and tell the governor.
What now? It's wreck time.
On your feet. If I say you come to the governor, you come. Now, move.
Oh, I cry out loud.
God, we could get into real strife because of that booze.
So what? I'm too worried about Lizzie.
Birdsworth. It's all right. You're being looked after now. You've been very, very sick. But you can relax now. You're in good hands, so just relax.
I know what happened. I know I was very sick. I was going along this passage. There was a beautiful bright light at the end. I was going towards it. I was going to be free. No worries.
Yes.
It was heaven. That bright light was heaven. I was going to heaven. Why didn't you let me go? I'm old. I'm old. I don't want to live anymore. Let me go.
Yes, Mr.
Miss Bennet?
All evidence of Birdsworth's home brew has disappeared, but I'm sure Smith knows all about it, so I've got her outside.
Good. Bring her in.
Inside, Smith.
Thank you, Miss Bennet.
Any news about Lizzie, Mrs. Davidson?
No, not yet. Miss Bennet tells me that the collapse was brought on by overexertion.
Yeah, you could say that, I suppose.
Trying to protect her home brew.
Look, Mrs. Davidson, it was just a lark. No real harm in it. Just something Lizzie cooked up on her own. No one else had anything to do with it.
I see. Miss Bennet says the brew's disappeared. Where is it?
It's been flushed down the loo. I'm getting it to you straight, Mrs. Davidson. I'm not trying to put one over you. Seeing what happened to Lizzie knocked the stuffing out of me a bit.
Very well, Smith. Under the circumstances, I don't see the necessity for taking this any further. But if there are any more attempts at making home brew, there will be severe punishments. Please make the women aware of that.
Yeah, I will.
I don't know why you didn't tell Miss Bennet the truth in the first place. After all, she probably saved Lizzie's life.
Yeah, you're right. She moved really quickly and knew what to do. None of us would have.
Miss Bennet is a good officer. A strict one, I know, but a good one. I think it's time the women change their attitude about her, don't you?
It'll be a bit hard, Mrs. Davidson, but we'll try. But only for Vera, Miss Bennet. Not that other rat bag.
If you are referring to Mr. Gillespie...
I thought you recognised the description.
He is no longer with us.
He's left.
That is correct.
That's the first decent thing that's happened all day.
All right, Smith, you may go.
Oh, there's one other thing, Mrs. Davidson. The telly's on the blink. Any chance of getting it fixed?
Well, that could be rather difficult. You see, after the pantomime, there wasn't any money left in the recreation fund.
Well, how about if we chip in from our earnings?
Well, yes, I could get a repairman then, if the other women are happy about that.
Oh, they will be. They missed their telly. And it'll give us something to take our minds off Lizzie. Thanks again, Mrs. Davidson.
Now, there's nothing to worry about. Just relax.
Just leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Mrs. Birdsworth, I know it's not very pleasant for you, but we have to do our best.
Why didn't you let me go when I wanted to?
Oh, come on. Life can't be that bad that you just want to throw it away.
72 years old and stuck in a bloody prison.
Prison. When they said Wentworth, I just assumed that they...
Been there for over 22 years now.
I didn't realise. How much longer are you going to be there?
I don't know. And I don't care.
That's incredible.
Yeah. And just when I thought I was on my way to heaven... You had to come along and stick your bloody beak in. Why'd you let me go? Oh, I want to go to sleep.
Yes. You go to sleep now.
Night.
Good night, Officer Powell.
Oh, Wendy, have you heard from the hospital?
No, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, well, I'll ring them myself later in the evening.
Night, Mrs. Davidson.
Mrs. Powell, what's your husband like as a handyman?
Oh, hopeless. What did you have in mind?
Well, we need someone to repair the women's TV set.
Ideally, as cheaply as possible. Well, if he touched it, it'd never work again. But look, there's old Mr. Humphreys who lives next door to us. He was a TV repairman before he retired.
Well, do you think he would fix ours for us?
Fixed ours on several occasions for almost nothing. Look, I'll ask him about it. He's a dear old thing. I'm sure he'll do it and he won't charge too much.
Good. I'm glad I asked you. Good night.
Good night.
Well, listen, Martin, I've got a story you might be interested in for that program of yours.
Always interested in a good story. What's it about?
Well, I've got a 72-year-old woman here. She's had a heart attack. But the interesting thing is that she's a prisoner from the Wentworth Detention Centre.
72 and still a prisoner. That could be interesting. I'll make a TV reporter of you yet, Trevor. Real sympathy angle. Good one.
Yeah, yes, that's what I thought. You might even be able to help me get the poor old love released. She's a bit of a hard case, but you can't help feeling sorry for her.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of interest in prisons at the moment, what with all the escapes and so on. Look, I'm a bit tied up at the moment, but I'll get back onto you about it tomorrow. Thanks for the thought.
Okay, then. I'll speak to you tomorrow. Bye.
I see. Yes. Thank you. Goodbye. Well, all they'd say was she's as well as can be expected.
Which doesn't really mean anything, does it?
No, afraid not. Well, at least she must be holding her own for the moment. Oh, Wendy, would you type a memo to each member of the staff this morning, please, telling them about the meeting?
Yes, I'll get onto it straight away.
Ah, Mrs. Davidson. This is Mr. Humphrey I spoke to you about.
How do you do, Mr. Humphrey?
Very well, thank you, Mrs. Davidson. Now, I believe you're having TV problems.
Yes, I'm afraid so. The women are really missing it.
Yes, I suppose they would. Well, I know what I'd be like if I couldn't watch the gardening program.
Of course, if it costs too much, we'll have to forget about it because the women are paying for it themselves and I don't want it to be too expensive.
Oh, you needn't worry about that, Mrs. Davidson. I'm retired now. Haven't got much to do with my time. I only charge for parts.
Oh, good. That will be wonderful. Thank you, Mr. Humphrey.
Wouldn't you reckon those buggers would let us know how Lizzie's getting on?
Maybe they don't even know themselves.
Yeah, vinegar tits wouldn't tell us even if she did.
Look, girls, I promised Mrs. Davidson that we'd try and be a bit nicer to Vera for what she did for Lizzie.
Yeah, I suppose we have to.
Hear that, girls? It has been nice to Vera week.
Yeah, sticking our throats a bit, though, isn't it?
Yeah, we'll make the effort.
Wish I was out with Judy. Lucky bugger.
Yeah, she really seems to have given them the slip this time, doesn't she?
Yeah, no word of her at all in the paper this morning, which means they've got no clues as to where she is.
Might be out of the country by now.
Yeah, on my money. Oh, well, good luck to them. Not that I care.
You're really going to miss that money when you get out there, Doreen.
I'll manage. I wouldn't have known what to do with it anyway.
Hi, girls.
Morning, Miss Bennett.
Morning, Miss Bennett.
Morning. Why aren't you working, Smith?
Sorry, Miss Bennett.
Mrs. Davidson has asked me to tell you that Birdsworth is as well as can be expected.
That tells us a lot.
Isn't it always the same with hospitals, Miss Bennett? They just never tell you nothing.
No.
Do you know if anybody's done anything about getting the telly fixed, Miss Bennett?
No, I don't. And if I had my way, you'd have no television, radio or newspapers.
But then we wouldn't know what was going on the outside, Miss Bennett.
That should be part of your punishment. In my opinion, you have far too many privileges.
Well, you are entitled to your opinion, Miss Bennett.
And don't think that you can get around me with all these Miss Bennets. I'm awake up to the lot of you.
You know, I don't think Vera liked us being nice to her. Really rattled her. Biggest favour we could do for her is to go back to being normal. I think old Vinegar likes it that way.
No doubt you all know by now that Mr. Gillespie is no longer with us.
That's a relief.
I agree he was a hard man to get on with, but I think we should stick to the regulations he brought in.
Well, I don't.
No, neither do I. It just made more work for all of us.
What do you think, Mr. Fletcher?
Well, I think he was inclined to take things to extremes.
Well, I'm glad the majority of you feel that way, because it's my intention to return to the old security methods.
Good.
The interior security gates will be kept unlocked again during the day, and armed guard duty is cancelled.
Thank heavens for that. Felt ridiculous wandering around with that rifle.
You wouldn't if you'd learned to use it properly.
Well, I couldn't shoot anyone anyway, so what's the point?
Exactly.
If I may continue, Mr. Fletcher will be in charge of maintaining the armory, but no weapons are to be issued without my explicit instructions. It will no longer be necessary for you to move in pairs, so that means new rosters will have to be drawn up. All right, Mr. Fletcher?
Yes, I suppose so. It might take me a little while to draw up a new roster, though.
Believe it or not, there is even more good news. An education facility is to be provided for the women and a trained teacher, so that it won't interfere with your normal duties. Something that should have been done some time ago, don't you think?
Oh, I think it's an excellent idea. A lot of the women have had very little education.
Do you really think this lot are interested in learning anything? They'll just try and twist the whole thing to use it against us. Well, it's a waste of government money, if you ask me.
I don't think anyone was asking you, Vera.
Hey, the telly's working.
Oh, good on you. Did you have much trouble with it?
Not once I found out what it was. Have you been playing around with it?
One of us? Not likely.
Well, I'd say somebody has. One of the valves had been taken out.
Oh, yeah, well, we know who that'd be, don't we, Doreen?
Yeah, bloody Gillespie. Mm.
Someone been giving you a hard time, ladies.
You could say that.
He was a real mongrel.
But we got rid of him, so it doesn't matter.
I get a feeling it'd be you. dangerous to cross you, lady.
My bloody oath it would. Hey, is it going to cost much?
Well, after hearing that, I wouldn't be game to charge you too much. Now, would I?
You're a bit of an old timer of this sort of lark, aren't you? Should you be at home with your feet up enjoying the pension?
Oh, I am retired. Just do a bit now and then to keep me hand in. Well, no good sitting around listening to your arteries harden. Got to keep going while you can.
Too bloody right.
Well, there you are. Good as new, eh? You shouldn't have any trouble with it, but if you do, just get him to call me again. The name's Sid Humphreys.
Nice to meet you, Sid. We don't get many men in here.
20 years ago, I might have given you all a run for your money.
Yeah?
Well, I'll slow down a bit since then.
Finished, Mr. Humphrey?
No, Mrs. Powell, just slow down a bit. Well, see you next time it goes bung.
Bye, Sid.
Bye, ladies.
He was a real nice old bloke, wasn't he?
Yeah, I bet he was a real goer at his time, too. Shame we had to come back in here when he was bastard.
Oh, were you able to repair the set, Mr. Humphrey?
Oh, yes, no trouble at all. I'll send you my bill, but it won't be much. Only had to replace a valve.
Bye, Sid.
That's very kind of you.
Not at all. Yeah. Listen, if there's anything else I can do around here, I'd be only too happy to help out. I'm a good handyman, but I can't earn too much, you see, because I'm on a pension, so I'll keep my charges low.
I'll certainly keep that in mind. Thank you very much.
Good heavens, you have a lot of bells going off around this place.
Yes, I'm afraid so. That's the lunch bell.
Yeah, I thought I was feeling a bit peckish. Oh, better get off and have a bite to eat myself. Oh, just let Colleen know if you want me to come in for anything.
I definitely will.
Nice to have something to fill the time. Since my wife passed on, you know.
Oh, Mr. Humphrey, if you only knew what you were letting yourself in for.
Do you reckon we'll hear anything about Judy on the telly tonight?
Fine, no. No news is good news, I reckon.
Quiet, please. The governor wants a word with you.
I don't want to interrupt your lunch. I just want to let you know there'll be some changes made in prison regulations.
Oh, Struth, what now?
Oh, I don't think you'll be unhappy about this. Everything is reverting to the way it was. The security measures brought in recently will be relaxed.
You mean everything's going back to the way it was before Gillespie stuck his beak in?
Yes, Doreen, that's exactly what I mean.
Yeah!
Oh, what are you doing?
You know, this is the first time I've seen you really relaxed.
Yeah, well, I could easily disappear away somewhere nice and quiet in the country. Suit me down to the ground.
Why don't you do it then?
Because of my friends in the prison. They are suffering under the hands of a little Hitler in there, and if I can do something about it, I'm going to.
And you're going to battle the injustices of the system all by yourself, huh?
Yeah, well, I got to start somewhere. I'm newsworthy at the moment. Probably the only time in my life someone will listen to me, too, I'll tell you.
Well, I guess you got to do what you feel's right. Calm down. Relax. I know who it is. Hi, Mickey.
Hi.
Good to see you.
Oh, didn't know you had a friend with you.
This is Judy Bryant. Mickey, my daughter.
Hi. Judy Bryant. Well, that rings a bell.
Oh, do. She's plastered all over the papers.
Oh, right, the prison thing. Don't tell me you've been hiding her at that.
Well, I picked her up on the side of the road, didn't I? Then I had to offer some hospitality, simple as it is.
Yes, of course. I was hoping that no one else would know I was here, Wally. Hey, look, you needn't worry about me. If Dad's decided you're right, you must be okay. He's a pretty good judge character.
Yes, I've made one or two mistakes in the time, but she's all right.
Dad been turning into vegetarian, has he? Yeah, well, I guess it's better than starving, isn't it? Just. So that must have taken a lot of guts to break out of that place. You reckon? I think it was pretty stupid. Unless by doing it, I'm able to help those left behind. How do you mean?
Oh, she's a lady with a mission.
Oh.
Right up your alley. Yeah. As a matter of fact, she's never happier than when she's crusading about something.
Is that true, is it? Yes, it is. Why don't you tell me what you're trying to do? Perhaps I can help in some way.
I wonder if that old bloke Sid could do with a few extra jobs. He said he was retired, so he can only be on the pension.
There's not much he can do around this place.
We could arrange it.
Oh, not the telly again. What if he has to take it away? Then we'll be stuck without it.
No, there are a few other jobs we could drum up for him. Give him a chance to earn a bit of extra money. What do you reckon?
No, all right. But what'll we do?
Well, give me a go. I want to think about it a bit.
Here we are, ladies.
Oh, Mrs. Jackson. I thought you'd forgotten us. Oh, Mrs. Morris, I mean.
That's all right. I keep forgetting myself.
Yeah, funny, isn't it?
There's a visitor for you, Doreen.
A visitor? Who'd be coming to see me?
Your solicitor?
Oh, yeah, about my trial.
Don't worry, love. You'll be all right. Yeah.
Can I get me buy up first?
Yes. He can wait.
Well, I think it's really tremendous that you want to help the others. Most people would lie low for a while and try and get out of the country.
Yeah, well, I thought of that, believe you me. But I decided that, maybe I could do some good for once in my life.
What's your plan?
I'm going to contact the prison reform group. I'm going to tell them about Gillespie, and then maybe they'll do something about getting rid of him.
If you write a letter, I'll deliver it for you.
Now, are you sure you want to get involved? You know, you could be brought up as an accessory.
I'm not worried about that. If I can help, I want to.
Well, honey, I'd hate to see you get in trouble because of me with the cops.
Oh, I've had a few brushes with the cops, student demonstrations, that sort of thing. Been fined and arrested 3 times.
Yeah, well, there's a hell of a difference between that sort of thing and doing a stretch inside. And that's exactly what'll happen to you if you get involved with me.
No, I'm not worried. This sounds like something I can do that'd be really worthwhile. So if there's a chance of changing the system, I'd like to be in on it.
Oh, God, we've got a budding revolutionist on our hands.
Yeah, well, don't make fun of me. I really do care about injustice. So, won't you let me help you with this?
Okay. After we down this muck, you can help me write a letter to the PRG, huh?
Look what we've got for you.
Where did that come from? I didn't ask for it.
Dr. Marsden thought it might cheer you up a bit. Would you like me to turn it on? Some good shows on this time of day.
I don't want to watch it.
All right. It's all plugged in. You just turn it on when you're ready. Oh, look at your lunch. You've hardly touched it.
I don't want it.
Got to eat something, Mrs. Birdsworth. Got to get your strength up.
I'm just not hungry.
Goodness me. What are we going to do with you? Didn't eat your breakfast either. If you don't eat something soon, we'll have to start feeding you intravenously. You don't want that, do you?
I don't care what you do. It doesn't matter to me anymore.
Now, don't talk like that, Mrs. Birdsworth. You've got to get your mind on getting better. Would you like me to get you a TV guide so you can see what's on this afternoon?
Just leave me alone.
All right. You get some sleep now. Perhaps you might feel up to more later on.
Well, this ought to make him sit up and take notice.
Well, it should. You've told it as it is. I'll get it to the PRG as soon as I can.
Thanks, honey.
Cup of tea on the go?
Oh, God. Not that herbal stuff you call tea, I hope. I'll never get used to it.
At least it doesn't poison the system with tannin.
What are you making now?
A couple of big water jugs. Trying a new glaze, too. Got a lot of cobalt in it. It's really beautiful.
Oh, I better go and investigate this.
Liking your girlfriend?
Girlfriend? If I tried anything with her, she'd chuck me through the nearest window.
She's not exactly a soft, feminine type like Mum, is she?
No, your Mum was soft and feminine, but a heart of solid, bloody steel. Is she still married to that insecticide manufacturer?
You ask me that every time you see me.
Always hope she'll come to her senses and leave him.
I'm not wise worth a million or so.
I'm glad she didn't suck you into that kind of lifestyle.
Last thing I want. You're too much like me, old man.
You always were my favourite kid.
You always were my favourite dad. Look, I must be off. Take care of Judy, won't you?
I don't think she needs much taken care of.
Yeah, I wouldn't like to see you back in that place, though. It sounds dreadful.
No, I'll try to see that that doesn't happen.
See you.
Bye.
I only took the baby because I didn't want it to be put into a home. I just wanted to look after it for Chrissy. She'll tell you that. She understands.
You feel she'll testify in your favour?
Oh, yeah, sure she would.
I see by your file you've been under a great deal of mental strain. You lost your own baby, didn't you?
Yeah, that's right. But I didn't take the baby because I thought it was mine or nothing. I mean, I knew it was Chrissy's and I was going to give it back to her as soon as she got out. I just wanted to look after her. I've been in homes and they're awful. Nobody gives a damn about you.
Well, it seems it might be possible we can establish you thought you were acting in the best interests of the baby.
Yeah, well, am I going to have to say much? Because I'm not real good at that, and I always seem to say the wrong thing.
You'll have to give evidence, Mrs. Burns. There's no way we can avoid that.
No, I suppose not.
But I think we can work up a good case. Of course, the escape attempt, that's another matter altogether.
Do you think they'll come down real heavy on me for that?
Well, to be honest, I think you'll probably have to expect the worst. It's not your first offence of this nature, and I don't think the judge will be inclined towards leniency this time.
It looks like I'm going to be stuck in here for bloody ever.
Oh, come on. It won't be that bad.
Won't it?
Went out to pick up a paper.
Yeah, I heard you go. I was just wondering where you were, that's all.
Look, you're safe here, Judy. I wouldn't turn you in, neither would Mickey.
I know that, Wally. I'm just a bit edgy today, you know? What's it say in the paper?
Oh, just a bit about prisons and escapees in general. Seems to have been a lot of escapes lately.
Say anything about me?
Yeah, you were ready to mention them.
Well, what does it say?
Better read it yourself.
This is under the heading of dangerous escapades. But I'm not dangerous.
It says likely to be violent.
Oh, well, that is terrific. That is fantastic. Now the cops will have a whole new attitude towards me.
How do you mean?
You know what violent means? Violent means shoot first, ask questions later. Damn it, I'm not violent.
Just give a good impression, huh?
Look. Throwing things about is one thing. Bashing people up is another. Now, I have never bashed up anyone in my whole life. Well, just a cop, that's all.
What cop?
When I escaped the first time, you see, I was in hospital. I had to knock this cop out to get away. I didn't want to do it, did I? There was no other way.
Well, maybe they saw that as being violent.
You don't like all this, do you?
No, I don't. That's why I live alone. There's enough violence in the world as it is, in the streets, marriage, violence against kids. I've seen it all. I don't like any of it.
Well, maybe I'd better get out of your hair then, since I'm so violent.
And where are you going to go? Come on, sit down. I'll make you another cup of tea. You never know, if you drink enough of the stuff, you might get to like it.
I'm sorry, Wally. It's just that I'm feeling as caged up in here lately as I did at Wentworth.
Judy, real prisons are in the mind. If you're truly free, you can be free anywhere.
Yeah, I know that. I think what's really bothering me is I'm worried about Mickey's involvement in all this.
Oh, you couldn't have kept her out of it.
Well, that's true, isn't it? I don't believe this. You know what they're saying here now? They're saying that they're going to step up the security measures at the prison. Don't they realize that if they rehabilitated the prisoners, they wouldn't need to step up the security measures?
Well, now you might get a chance to get that point of view across, eh?
Well, I'm going to try, Wally. Even if it means getting caught.
It seems incredible to me. Here's the paper calling for tighter security measures in prisons. And what are we doing? Slackening our security measures.
Mrs. Davidson's just trying to make this place bearable for officers and inmates alike.
But the moment we lower our guard, these animals take advantage of it. Mrs. Davidson's too soft.
I suppose you'd prefer Mr. Gillespie.
As far as tighter security measures, yes, I do. These animals are...
They are not animals, Vera. They are human beings, just like you and me.
Well, suit yourself. I don't want to be classed in with that lot.
Look, I know some of these women will never be anything else but crims. But given the chance, some of these women could make a better life for themselves. That article completely ignores rehabilitation.
And how many of these women do you think want to be rehabilitated?
Well, not in those terms, perhaps. But given the chance for a better life, most of them would take it.
They'd laugh in your face. They're happy in the gutter.
Well, I don't agree. I'm glad we're getting an education program. And if they apply themselves, some of these women could get decent jobs when they leave here.
If they apply themselves. But I'm sure they won't be interested.
Well, we'll see. I just think they'd be a lot happier if they had something constructive to occupy their minds. We should be right behind the project.
What is it this time?
I just thought this would be handy for you with the telly, so you don't have to lean forward to change channels. See? You just press any button you want for the channel.
I don't want any of it. You can take the whole thing away as far as I'm concerned.
But Dr. Marsden hired it for you himself. Take your mind off things a bit. Come on, Mrs. Birdsworth. Just give it a try.
Well,
there you are.
We used to have
you just keep pressing the buttons till you find something you want.
Bloody rubbish.
And was rushed to Wentworth Hospital after suffering a near-fatal heart attack. Considering the circumstances I've described of her previous 20 years of imprisonment for a crime she did not commit, it seems incredible that this old and feeble woman was eventually returned to prison on lesser charges. We put forward a strong and urgent plea that immediate action be taken for her release.
Why can't they leave me alone?
From the sad case of Lizzie Birdsworth, we turn to a happier subject. The breeding of border collies.
Leave me alone. Just leave me alone.
Until tomorrow, this is Graham Hopkins bidding you good night.
Well, fancy Lizzie getting all that publicity, eh?
Yeah, terrific. Oh, but maybe it isn't.
What do you mean?
Well, you know how Lizzie feels about leaving here. She wouldn't want to leave all her friends. She mightn't take kindly to somebody trying to get her released.
Oh, no, she wouldn't either. I hope she wasn't watching. It might upset her.
She wouldn't have a telly, though, would she?
Nah, probably not. Just as well. Might be just the thing to start her off again.
Yeah.
Mickey's lucky.
Huh?
Oh, I was just thinking that you two like each other a lot.
Yeah, I guess we do.
You know, my dad didn't like me much. Not even when I was little. He liked my sister. Mind you, she was a pretty one. Cute as a button, Shirley Temple curls, the whole bit.
Yeah, well, Mickey's pretty, but that's not the reason I love her. She's a gutsy kid, not frightened to make a decision.
I noticed that.
Speak of the devil, here she is.
Oh, I wonder if she remembered to deliver the letter.
G'day, didn't expect to see you again today.
Hi. Hi, I just wanted to see Judy.
Oh, everything okay?
Yes, of course. Just thought you might like the clothes you asked for.
Oh, thanks. Ooh, a bit girly, aren't they?
I also thought you might be interested in the current affairs program I saw on TV tonight. It was about a prisoner from Wentworth, Elizabeth something.
Elizabeth?
Yes, she's an old woman.
Lizzie Birdsworth?
Yeah, she's in hospital.
What's wrong with her?
Well, a heart attack. Anyway, the current affairs program is playing for public sympathy, pleading for her release.
Is she going to be okay?
Well, they didn't say. They said it was near fatal.
Well, there you go, you see. Had it all been my fault, the escape would have brought that on.
Well, listen, can't you see this will be the perfect opportunity for you?
What do you mean?
I see what Mickey's getting at. It created a lot of interest in Wentworth.
Yeah, well, if you can tell them that conditions inside contributed to this old woman's heart attack, well, they've got to listen. So why don't you arrange a meeting with this current affairs program guy?
What?
Well, a secret meeting. He could interview on camera.
Well, that'd be a bit dangerous, wouldn't it?
Yeah, but think of the coverage you'd get. You'd have a chance to tell thousands of people about the conditions in places like Wentworth.
Now, hang on a minute. Don't you rush me in anything, huh?
Yeah, that's right. Mickey's like a bull at a gate. You take your time to think about it.
Well, I'm going to have to, because I can't afford to take any chances now.
Yeah, well, don't think about too long, because if this Lizzie dies...
Don't say that. Lizzie is not going to die. She's a tough old bird.
All right, if she gets well, then, whichever way it goes. She's big news now, but she won't be for long. All I'm saying is, don't miss your chance.
Okay. Now, you just hang in there a minute, because I'm the one that has to make the decisions, huh?
Good morning.
Oh, good morning, Mrs. Davidson.
Almost time for you to go home and get some rest, isn't it, Mrs. Morris?
Yes, I've just finished this and then I'll be off. I want to visit Lizzie sometime this morning. I have a letter here from Mrs. Huntley that should cheer her up.
Oh, good. I hope she wasn't watching television last night.
Yes, I heard some of the women talking about it. Do you think there'll be some pressure to have her released?
Well, I imagine there will be. No one would believe that Lizzie wants to stay in here, or at least until the Huntleys get back from America.
Yes, it's a bit hard to explain, isn't it? I mean, who'd believe anyone would want to stay in prison?
Well, I hope if she was watching last night, she's not too depressed about it. Try and reassure her as much as you can when you see her this morning.
Yes, I will.
And give her my best wishes. I don't think I'll get a chance to see her. I was talking to her doctor yesterday, and he seems to think she's over the worst of it. What she needs most at the moment is the will to go on living.
Well, I think I might have the answer here.
I hope so.
Oh, Doreen wants to speak to you.
Well, could you bring her in before you go?
Yes, of course.
I was wondering if I could go and visit Lizzie, Mrs. Davidson.
I'm sorry, Doreen, but with your trial tomorrow, I can't let you leave the prison before then.
But that means she won't have any visitors.
Oh, yes, she will. Mrs. Morris is going to visit her this morning.
Oh, are you? That'll be real good. Would you give her my love and tell her why I can't come?
Yes, of course, Doreen.
You can go now if you like, Mrs. Morris.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Davidson. Well, I'll do my best to cheer her up.
I reckon she'll need it after that TV show last night. You know how she feels about leaving here. She's got no friends out there.
Oh, I wouldn't worry too much, Doreen.
What do you mean by that, Mrs. Davidson?
She has some news for Lizzie. Now then, Doreen, I think we should discuss your trial.
Oh, I don't even want to think about it.
Well, you really don't have much choice about that, Doreen. I've spoken to your solicitor and he seems to think the court will be lenient over your kidnapping charge. I've been called as a defence witness and I shall certainly do all I can to help you.
Yeah, well, thanks, Mrs. Davidson, but what about the escape charge? He reckons I'll really cop it for that.
Oh, we can't be too sure about that. You never know, you might get a sympathetic judge. Anyway, I wouldn't get depressed about it. You've got to present yourself as well as possible tomorrow.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to impress anyone, am I?
Doreen, you've been through a great deal of emotional stress. It won't be overlooked. It may go better than you expect. Now then, you mustn't let yourself get defeated before you get there.
Okay, Mrs. Davidson, I'll give it a go.
Well?
Well, of course we're well. It comes naturally with good food, clean air, and relaxed living.
Dad, you know what I mean.
Did you deliver my letter to the PRG?
Yes, but I think you'd be a lot smarter to stick with the other idea.
You mean to contact that TV journalist, huh?
Yes, of course I do. What have you decided?
Well, Mickey, I'm not sure.
Come on, you told me you'd give me the answer this morning. It'd be great. I thought and thought about
it. Yes, so have I, all night.
Well, you must say it'd be a terrific follow-up to the Lizzie Burswell story.
Honey, I know you think that this is a great golden opportunity for us. It's just that I'm not sure we can trust those people.
I reckon you're a fool if you do. Your recapture would be a good story. I reckon they'd opt for that.
You think they'd tell the cops?
Could do. I don't think it's worth the risk.
That's what I reckon.
Oh, look, I don't agree.
Well, it's not your neck, is it? Look, Mickey, if I get recaptured and sent back inside, everything I've been trying to do, everything will mean nothing. I couldn't bear that, honey. A lot of people have suffered because of me. Lives have been lost. I want to make it up to them, you know that? I'm not just going to throw everything away on something that's so damned risky.
Oh, but you've got
don't
to see...
Don't push it, Mickey. She's made up her mind.
I'm sorry, darling. It was a good idea, you know?
Oh, okay. I thought you might get cold feet, so I've come up with an alternative suggestion.
Just like a mother. Can't take no for an answer.
Look, it's nearly as good, but there's absolutely no danger involved. I think it's a brilliant idea.
Modest young thing, this daughter of mine, huh?
Well, they've got this video outfit at the university. I'm sure we can borrow it to make a tape ourselves.
You mean of me?
Yes. And you can make all the points that you made in your PRG letter, but make them personally. It'd have a lot more impact on the general public.
I suppose it would.
And what a scoop for the TV channel. A tape of an escapee still on the loose talking about the circumstances that forced her into escaping.
The current affairs people would jump at it.
Yeah, well, they give it a lot of publicity too. You get a lot of people on your side, Judy.
I like it.
Well, let's do it.
That's a good girl, Mrs. Birdsworth.
Is it all right for me to see her?
I don't really think she should have any visitors. It'll have to be very brief.
Yes, I understand.
Mrs. Jackson.
Hello, Lizzie.
Well, perhaps a visitor might help.
Thought these might brighten up the room for you.
Oh, they're lovely, Mrs. Jackson.
Hey, it's Mrs. Morris now, remember?
I keep forgetting.
You were Mrs. Jackson for such a long time.
Yes, yes, I suppose I was. Well, how are you feeling?
Not much chop. I don't know why they didn't let me go. I reckon me time's up.
Oh, of course it isn't.
I can't see that I've got much to live for.
Well, have a read of this. It's from Ellen and Joseph.
Oh, Josie's a lot better.
Yes.
Bloody hell. Ellen's fallen in love. It's a bloke, the father of one of the other patients.
Yes, I know. Read what else it has to say.
They're going to get married. Oh, that's good, isn't it, Mrs. Morris? That means Josie's going to have a dad. Oh, but that means they're going to live over there. I might never see them again.
Lizzie, read the rest of the letter.
But I don't seem to be able to see it proper.
And of course, Mum, we want you to come over here and live with us. Josie and me are longing to see you again. We'll have a lovely home. Donald is such a nice man and is looking forward to meeting you. He'll send you the money for your fare as soon as you can manage to come. Until then, Mum, goodbye. Love, Ellen.
They want me to go to America?
Yes, they're waiting for you.
Oh, bloody beauty bottle.
Now, take it easy, Lizzie. Calm down.
Is everything all right?
Oh, everything's bonza. I'm going to live in the US of A. What do you reckon about that, eh?